This is a Cooler Master HAF 700 EVO full tower case. It's really very big and heavy. Large panels here. And temperature CPU indicator in the front. I'll plug this later so that you guys can see it. It's really very spacious. You could put thick 360 millimeter radiators in a push-pull configuration, and you still would have a lot of space left. Okay. Okay, let's try to start working on the build. So here's the build now. I've installed the motherboard, the block for the GPU, radiators, fans, and I've also done removing some of the panels, the steel panels, because whenever I'm gonna put a pass-through or a fitting on the backside, this helps to clear the fittings on the backside, so it would not touch the back cover of the case. So I adjusted it further front. So now the acrylic is done and painted. It's mounted on a thick acrylic, aluminum on both sides. Okay. And then I've also made bent a thick acrylic to hold the GPU so it would not sag up or down or left to right, so it's very secure. So, and two stainless bolts screwed on the back plate, because And then the acrylic is also mounted on the case. I would also be making another acrylic that bends to cover these parts of the case. So it's not much, but it will make the build look much, much cleaner. Okay, now I've started bending the acrylic frosted tubes. So guys, this is the most difficult part of doing hardline tubing, you know, because you have to measure it perfectly, how you bend it, how you mark it. But this will help you in your future if ever you gonna do some other builds. So now I'm going to do the third bend here, going to the pass-through. So what you have to do, or it would help the tubing to be more leveled and, you know, more accurate, is first you have to properly level the tube before marking it. Like, for example, here's square, so I have to do it like that and then make sure that this tube, this part, also level on the other side. Okay, and then it is leveled on this side. So you have to check if it's squared on three sides. So it's also, you have to see if it's leveled here on top. Okay, level on the side. Okay, and level here. Okay, and when you've done that, you would still have to, I use an old tube, okay, and then I also level this one, okay, on this side and on this side, so that you would have a perfect perfect way to know where the tube's gonna go, and then you'll start marking it. Okay, like this one. Every time you should mark on the inside of the tubing, that's where the tube's gonna go. Like, for example, you don't mark here, because if you mark here, okay, like then, and then you bend, the tube's gonna go way off the pass-through fitting. Okay, so what you do is you mark the inside part. Okay, so yeah, I hope this helps you. This process takes a very, very long time. You need lots of patience, lots of time. You have to do it over and over again. After you level this one, you have to check again the lower part, and then check again here, because this is not fixed, it will move. Okay, so every time you have to check, you have to have patience. And but in the end, you know, it's gonna look better, cleaner, and you know, every part that you give, let's say you give an effort on the tube layout or the bending, you know, and then it will turn out great. So just have patience when doing this, and then this takes a very long time to master where you mark, how you bend. There's no magic or tool to use for it to be, you know, perfectly aligned on the holes that the tube's gonna go. You know, this takes practice, repetition, you know. So I hope this helps you guys in your future builds or your projects on your custom water cooled build. So yeah, in the future, I'm little by little, I'm gonna give you some hints, tips, or yeah, just to help you guys out. Thank you. So for almost 3 days, I'm measuring, marking, cutting, and bending. This took me almost 3 days. Four tubes here, the tubes connecting the 360 millimeter radiator from the bottom to the top radiator. So you see everything is aligned on this side, on this side, and of course on the front. Okay, so also the tubings on the back is done connecting the tubes on the front. So here it is. Okay, so I haven't worked on the cable management. I'll do that later when I install the power supply and the sleeve cables. Okay, this four tubes I will still remove. Okay, because I'm gonna fit the acrylic cover that I will put on this part. Okay, and then I'll still refine and adjust the length of some tubes because it's off around 1 or 2 millimeters, so I need to refine it more so it would be much accurate or much aligned for what I wanted. So yeah, I've removed this maybe around several many times to adjust. So yeah, I'll be removing it again for the last time. So okay, and hopefully the next video it's gonna be the installation, but first I'm gonna do this acrylic, cutting it, marking it, and then painting it, and then the cable management.